So today we are going to visit Peru.
Okay, ma'am. 1 second. Subhanita, see this chat.
Tanvi, you can have your personal gossip at the end.
What's the school name?
SSM Virtual School to Peru. So first, we'll have a look to the geography of this place. So as you can see the map of the Peru right here. So it lies within the side of South America. So Peru is a country on the central western coast of South America facing the Pacific Ocean. So it lies wholly in the southern hemisphere, as you can see in this picture. So its northmost extreme reaching to 1.8 minutes of latitude or about 3.3 kilometers south of the equator. So the Peru shares land border with Ecuador, Colombia, Brazil, Bolivia, and Chile, with its longest land border shared with Brazil. So Peru has a total land area of 13,799 kilometers square. And it has total of the water areas 5,000 kilometers square. So now here you can see the political map of this country, as well as you can see the neighboring countries as well. As I told, it shares the longest land boundary with Brazil. So in Peru, there are total 196 provinces, which are grouped into 25 regions, except for Lima province, which does not belong to any region. So this makes an average of 7 provinces per region. Please stop annotating. So now we're gonna have a little introduction to the country. So Peru is a large country and encompasses an area of dramatic landscapes, as you can see in these pictures.
Rudy, please stop. Ma'am, can you remove the annotation request?
Rudy, don't play with the settings and don't send the request.
Ma'am, can you remove? It's very disturbancy.
Okay, I'll just share again. Rudy, this is the last warning for you. Okay, so is it clear now?
Yes, ma'am, it's clear. Now
okay.
You can.
Okay. So Peru is a large country and encompasses an area of dramatic landscapes. So a Peruvian tour may include high mountains, sandy beaches, and sweltering jungle. The long coast of Peru is studded with cliffs and hills, and there are some more beautiful beaches on the northern end for the travelers interested in surfing and sunbathing. The southern coast recedes into a desert with stunning sand dunes and paths. So adventurous travelers won't want to miss the Colca Canyon, which is also found in southern Peru near the beautiful white city of Arequipa. So here you can see a few glimpse of this place. Like you can see the mountain view and all. Now coming up to the next. Okay, so the capital of Peru is Lima, which is also known as the City of Kings. Now talking about the national flag. The national flag of Peru consists of 3 vertical bicolors of red, white, and game red. So Peruvians celebrate their flag annually on June 7th. In the country, the flag is recognized as the right representation of the country, its people and its history, as well as a symbol of victory over Spanish rule. Now, as I mentioned about the Spanish rule over this country, now we'll look about the ancient history of this place and then the recent history. So what does the ancient history tell us? So the region, which is now known as Peru, has a mythical history. So human habitation is documented as early as the 8th millennium BC. Organized village patterns developed and several distinct Peruvian culture began to emerge by 1500 BC. So the Chavin and the Sachin are the best known of these early civilizations. They left behind advanced stone carvings of religious iconography, usually involved of jaguar. As this culture declined, a second wave of distinctive civilization rose in their place. The Paracas and the Salina left behind sophisticated weaving and kiln-fired ceramics as the legacy. So from the Paracas culture emerged the mysterious Nazca. So this is all about the ancient history. Now moving forward to the recent history of this place. So Peru remained a Spanish colony through the next few centuries. So even as War of Independence rocked the rest of the South America, Peru was a royalist stronghold. It was the last country to gain its independence in 1821. The fledgling country rocked between military rule and political infighting. Peru engaged in war with Chile and in the War of Pacific from 1879 to 1883, in which they were defeated. So military groups, political turmoil, and the radical reform characterized the country for the next several decades. Now, talking about the Peruvian culture. So its culture is a beautiful mix of Hispanic and Native traditions. The Quechua and the Aymara are the two main native cultures of the Peru, both of whom speak their native languages. So these Inca descendants have successfully preserved and developed up their proud cultures despite the creeping in of globalization. So in fact, the old Inca seat of Cusco is still perceived as a cultural capital of the country by many. So talking about the Peruvian dress. So Peruvian typical dress is beautiful. You can see here a few images. So in some region, the women wear layers of bright skirts called poleras. So they name their skirts as poleras. And some wear black skirts with a wide embroidered belt or cotton petticoats underneath with elaborate designs. So Peruvian ponchos are a necessity in the highlands where the cold can be harsh. The ponchos of Cajamarca and Puno are the long and dramatic, whereas those of Cusco are shorter. So woolen or straw hats are also common, as you can see over here in these pictures. Now talking about the architecture of this place. So some of the Peru's architecture is breathtaking. The colonial city of Arequipa is the perfect example. So white cathedrals and facades rise out of cobblestone streets, and there are architectural treasures dotting the winding avenues from old monasteries to the mansions and the cottages. Okay, so talking about the Peru, can anybody tell me the one of the famous spot of this place? Do you know any famous spot of this place? Have you ever heard about Machu Picchu?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. So here is a picture. So have you seen this place before?
Yes, ma'am. It is the most location that people want to go.
Yes.
Ma'am.
So, yes.
Ma'am, it is a face in Machu Picchu.
Okay. So, thank you for your response. So, in the realm of the ancient architecture, the lost city of Machu Picchu is unparalleled in its engineering and the location. So, the stone temples and salons rise directly out of the mountain's peak that falls away on all sides to the river below. The terraced gardens revealed agricultural advances of the Incas, and the astrological makers show the incredible precision and knowledge of celestial events. So the lost city is one of the world's great wonders. Now moving towards the Peruvian music. So Peruvian music is distinctive, and Peruvian tour will likely feature several tastes of it. So it's a blend of pre-Columbian influences of wind instrument and drums with delicate Spanish string instruments. Now talking about the language. So languages of Peru. So Peru has many languages in use, and one of its official languages is Spanish, that has been in the country since it began being taught in the time of George Pardo, instead of country's main language, especially the languages in the Andes. So as India, Peru is also a multilingual language country. Now, in the beginning of the 21st century, it was estimated that in this multilingual country, about 50 very different and popular languages are spoken. So there are 72 languages if dialects are considered. The majority of these languages are indigenous, but the most common language is Spanish. The main language is about 82.6% of the population speaks, and Spanish is followed by the country's indigenous languages. Now talking about the weather of this place. So Peru's weather varies with its landscape. The rainy season throughout the country occurs from January to March. The sun seekers should know that although it's very somewhat humid, the coast is very warm at this time. A perpetual mist characterizes the beaches for the rest of the year. Now we'll come up with the cuisine. So Peruvian cuisine is quickly becoming the world famous. So a traditional Peruvian staple such as maize, potatoes, and rice have been combined with Spanish, Basque, and Asian food to evolve into a sophisticated genre. So a cruise to Peru will most certainly feature some of the culinary luxuries. So incredible ceviches and other fish dishes can be found along with the coast. These dishes are usually combined with milk, chili, pepper, or potatoes for a Peruvian distinction. Tamils and the humitas are the common in other areas, as are variety of potatoes-based dishes. These are usually served with soup. So delicious soups or stews accompany almost every Peruvian meal. Now talking about the national animal. So can anybody tell me the national animal of Peru? I can show you the picture also.
Ma'am, I know it. Ma'am, can I tell? My name is Tanvi.
Yes.
It's a vicuna.
Yes.
Vicunus, ma'am.
So you can see a picture also.
It's like an ostrich, ma'am. Ostrich animal.
Yes. Yes. Okay, so the
deer and the neck is like ostrich.
Yes, yes. So the
vicunias.
Okay.
There are two extra letters in Spanish.
Yeah. So can I proceed? So the Inca valued vicunas highly for their wool. And it was against the law for the anyone but royalty to wear vicuna garments. Today, the vicuna is the national animal of Peru and appears on the Peruvian coat of arms. So their wool is used to make garments. Okay, coming up to the national bird. Who's going to tell me?
Monkey.
So I can show you the picture also. So can anybody tell or guess?
It looks very funny.
Although it's really beautiful.
Eyes, ma'am. Eyes okay, is looking
so
funny.
So the national bird is Cotinga.
Cotinga.
Yeah. So known
he
as...
Looks very, he looks so weird.
Yeah. Okay, so Cotinga is the national bird of Peru. So known as the Tulkin Quechua.
Hey, this, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, like peacocks, why does he have like that? Like on the his head, like why does he have like a crown?
Because it is the natural creature, right? So how could I tell you that? Okay.
Ma'am.
So Cotinga. it is also known as the Tulkin Quechua. This Katinga is the national bird of Peru and is related to other distinctive tropical fruit eaters such as the banded Katinga. So, further, I have a video for you all.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Oh, can I?
Wait, I'll let you know.
Ma'am? Ma'am, can I present?
Wait, I'll let you know. Okay. So, I hope you all have liked this video, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, okay, so all those who want to present today, please raise your hand. And then we'll make you co-host one by one. Okay, so we have Tanvi today. Okay, so first, Tanvi, you can start making
me
co-host.
Make me co-host, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, after Tanvi, I can share.
Have you made the presentation?
Ma'am, this is Kiona speaking.
Yes, Kiona, have you made the presentation?
Yes.
Okay, please raise your hand.
Ma'am?
Yes, Subhanita.
Ma'am, can I present a small video, please, ma'am?
Subhanita, we can't accept the videos. If you wish to present anything, we will consider this presentation.
Indeed, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am,
Nisa.
Today I saw on YouTube that my presentation was on the YouTube.
Okay, so Tanvi, I guess you are co-host now.
No, ma'am, you didn't make us a co-host. Make me a co-host.
Okay, we are making you co-host.
Okay, ma'am, can I please do one time, please, ma'am?
Subhanita, like we have already mentioned, if you wish, you can show us the presentation, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am. Ma'am, now I can present?
Yes, sure.
Ma'am, the host disabled the participant screen sharing. You didn't make me a co-host. Now you make me, ma'am. Wait, I'll share. Hi everyone, I'm going to tell you places of Peru, and this is the map of Peru, and Peru is the third largest country in South America, and the flag of Peru, this is the flag of Peru and the national emblem in it, and this is the famous foods of Peru. And the president of Peru is Francisco Sagasti. And the national animal is Bicuna. And this is the national game of Peru.
Can you tell the name of the national game?
One second. I'll tell you. Plate, palte, fronton.
Paleta fronton.
Paleta fronton. And the next one I'll show you once again. And this is the best places to visit. This is Machu Picchu. And this is Lake Titicaca. And the second one I'll show you. Nazca Lines. And this is the best place to visit. This is Nazca Lines. And this is Who is a Karen? National Park. It will be very cold there. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Tanvi. It was a really beautiful presentation.
Okay, ma'am. One second, ma'am.
Okay, now you can stop sharing your screen. So next we have Fiona.
Ma'am, can you make me the co-host?
Yes, we are making you co-host. Then we don't play with the settings.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, Tanvi sent me something to invite. She invited
decline.
Me to
room decline.
One. I declined decline. Only.
Yeah.
Ma'am, by mistake it happened.
Okay, so now we have another presentation from Fiona.
Can you all see the screen?
Yes, it's visible.
We are going to visit Peru today. So this is the capital of Peru. And this is the map of Peru and the rest of the flags. And now we have Machu Picchu. And this is the face. This is the currency. This is the currency of Peru. And this is the other currency, means the note of Peru. And after that, we have the clothes. And this is the president. And thank you.
Thank you, Fiona. Okay, so can you tell me the name of the currency? What is the currency called of Peru? You have shown the picture.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's named as Sol. S-O-L, Sol.
Sol.
Yes. Okay. So they have notes like we have 10 rupee, 20 rupee notes. So similarly, they have notes as 10 Sol, 20 Sol, 100 Sol or 50 Sol.
Okay.
Yes.
Ma'am.
Yes. Thank you, Ken.
Ma'am, Monday.
Thank you, Kendrick.
My mouth is bleeding, so I'll drink some water, ma'am, once again.
Okay, so for tomorrow, we are going to visit Philippines. So if anybody wants to give presentation.
The video, ma'am, that's all.
Okay, so that was all about our today's session. I hope you have enjoyed your trip to the Peru with me. So for tomorrow, we will be going to visit Philippines, a new destination with the new pilot. So stay tuned and stay excited.
Ma'am, what is the country tomorrow?
Bye, ma'am.
Philippines.
Bye, ma'am. Bye, Manbir, ma'am.
Bye, Subhanita.
Bye,
Manjam. Bye. Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, Manbir. Bye, Nessa.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, Kiana.
Meet you tomorrow, Kiana. Meet you tomorrow, Tanvi. Bye.